morning, and we start with this lecture 4, the density of states. The topic is density of states. Density of state. Usually the name indicates what it refers to, density of states. So density, this gives us an idea that it must be something to do per unit volume. States. What is a state? State. State is an allowed solution to the boundary value problem. State is an allowed solution which satisfies the boundary conditions. This is a general definition of a state or a solution, an eigen solution or a mode. Different names are used, but a state is an allowed solution that satisfies the boundary conditions. So we are referring to the density of states in semiconductors, which is rho of k, denoted by rho of k or rho of e. This is in the k space, rho of k, which is in the k space. What is this k and k space? We will see. Rho of k, rho of e. Now, rho of k is defined as rho of k dk. Rho of k dk is the number of states between k and k plus dk. It is the number of states between k and k plus dk per unit volume of the material. Per unit volume of the material. This is the definition of rho of k. Exactly like this, you can also define rho of e, that is rho of e dE is the number of states between e and e plus dE per unit volume of the material. What are these e and k? E and k is the one which defines the band structure or the EK diagram that we have seen in the last class. So if you see a typical EK diagram, so E here and K, you can draw wherever EK. As you can see, for every given value of K, there is a corresponding value of E. So there is a K here and there is a E here. Therefore, if I go to the next step, that is K plus DK, so K plus DK, then correspondingly I have E plus DE. This is K, corresponding to that I have an E value. And if I say that this is K plus DK, then corresponding to that I have E plus DE. The number of states between K and K plus DK here. So what is this? These are the allowed solutions, allowed energy values as a function of k. So the number of states means the number of points that we get here in the EK diagram between k and k plus dk is the same as number of points between E and E plus dE. So obviously rho of k dk is equal to rho of E. We will use this shortly. This is the first picture of the density of states. Before I proceed with the density of states and see what are these states, how many, what is the number of states which is available between k and k plus dk, let me recall a few things from the EK diagram that we have studied in the last class. K, E. This corresponds to the, as I have shown already, this corresponds to the valence band and this corresponds to the conduction band. That is, this is the energy value EC and here is the energy value EV. And of course, this is the band gap EG. So, this is the familiar band diagram. This is valence band and conduction band. We have seen that normally the typical number of electrons in the valence band is of the same order as the number of atoms in the valence band, which we have calculated in an earlier lecture, is of the order of 10 to the power of 22 per cc, the number of electrons in a band. And generally, if you take silicon, for example, intrinsic silicon, then the intrinsic carrier concentration, Ni, at room temperature is of the order of 10 to the power of 10 per cc, 10 to the power of 10 per cc. As I discussed in the last class, it depends on the band gap and typical intrinsic concentration is this much. And if you dope the semiconductor to make a device, say a PN junction device, typical doping concentration could be anywhere from 10 to the power of 12 to 10 to the power of 17, which means the number of carriers which are available is of this order or of the order of 10 to the power of 15. The number of carriers, which means the number of carriers available in the conduction band here, is of the order of 10 to the power of 15 per cc. There are devices which are heavily doped where it may be 10 to the power of 18 or 10 to the power of 19 per cc is the carrier concentration. In a band, there are typically 10 to the power of 22 electrons. And the carriers which are available, which means the holes in a semiconductor valence band, holes in a valence band, or electrons in the conduction band, is of the order here, which means it is much smaller compared to the total number of electrons in the band. And therefore, if we consider the EK diagram, these carriers which are available, they are occupying only the bottom portion of the band. We have holes here in the EK diagram and electrons here, which are literally in the bottom portion of the band. Because the number is so small, they always tend to remain near the bottom. If you have a hot electron, this is the term used, hot electron means an electron with higher energy. It will come down, it will trickle down by a phenomena called thermalization. We will discuss more about this later when we introduce phonons. So, it will thermalize and come back to the bottom. Therefore, in all devices, when you want to analyze device characteristics, normally it is sufficient if you know these, the EK variation near the bottom itself, because almost all carriers, the holes and the electrons, are accumulated near the bottom. And at the bottom, near the bottom here, the variation is nearly parabolic. This variation here is nearly parabolic, and we use what is called parabolic approximation of the band. Parabolic approximation. which means the energy E of an electron in the conduction band is given by E is equal to Ec plus h cross square k square divided by twice mc. H cross square k, where mc is the effective mass. Mc is the effective mass in the conduction band. Effective mass of electrons in the conduction band. And Eb, that is energy in the valence band, this is for the conduction band. And for the valence band, this is given by Eb minus h cross square k square divided by twice mv, where mv is the effective mass in the valence band, effective mass of holes in the valence band. This is called parabolic approximation because, as you can see, the dependence of E is parabolic. It depends on k square. It varies as k square. That is why you can see this variation is like k square. Ec, so anywhere if you go here for a given value, a particular value of k here, then you have Ec plus this variation, which is h cross square k square by 2mc. In the last class, we discussed that by using the effective mass, you can treat the carrier as a free particle. The kinetic energy of a free particle is given by p square by 2m, p square by 2m. So the kinetic energy is equal to p square by 2m, and p is h cross k, so that is why we have h cross square k square divided by 2m. So here at the bottom of the band, k equal to 0, and therefore there is no kinetic energy, but as you go to a finite k value, you have h cross square k square by 2m. And this is called parabolic approximation. If you see the whole band, it will not go parabolically. It will change if you see the whole band. But normally, if you are interested in the bottom of the conduction band and the top of the valence band, this approximation is a very good approximation. Parabolic approximation. Okay? And we will use this parabolic approximation in deriving the density of states. Because in most practical cases, that is sufficient. And as practicing engineers, we do not worry so much about the rigor. But the second point that I discussed in the last class was the effective mass. Which is also given by, so m star, that is mc or mv, depending on which was equal to 1 over h cross square d square e by dk square powers minus 1. Now I want to show you some typical values of the effective mass in some semiconductors. Some of the semiconductor materials, silicon, germanium, gallium arsenide, indium phosphide, gallium phosphide, these are widely used materials in optoelectronics. There are many more semiconductors, of course. In optoelectronics, these are some of the important semiconductors which are used. What you notice is that the effective mass in silicon here, in the conduction band, valence band, effective mass of holes. In germanium here, these are the values. In gallium arsenide, you note that these are the values. In fact, there are something called light holes and heavy holes. But here we are mainly considering the heavy holes. I do not wish to introduce light holes and other bands at this stage. So what I would like you to note is also that smaller the effective mass, larger is the mobility. You can see, smaller the effective mass, larger is the mobility. Mobility of electrons is much more compared to the mobility of holes. So the band structure tells us an effective mass, and it also tells us what is the corresponding mobility. Now, what is this effective mass? Let's have a little bit more of this picture. The rest mass is m0 and effective mass is much smaller. It is like this. Effective mass is the mass experienced or the mass exhibited by an electron, the mass exhibited by an electron when inside the semiconductor. It is like this. You have a long wooden log. You try to drag it on the ground. It's very heavy, really heavy. You will not be able to drag it if the log is very big. Now you put that log in water, and now you can pull it much easily because water's buoyant force is giving an upward thrust, and that log is feeling now much lighter, and you can pull it without any difficulty. It is acting as if it's a very light particle. It's why? Because it is in the medium. That log is in water. Exactly like that, when the electron is inside a semiconductor, it is moving under the influence of the internal electric field, the internal electric field within the medium. So it's like a cushioning effect. So there are potential variations, and the electron is as if it is cushioned and moving very smoothly. That is why it feels very light, and that is why the effective mass that you can see is much smaller in the conduction band of electrons. Accordingly, the mobility is much higher. Now, let me come back to the density of states. So now we have to understand what is this k and what values can k take. We know that for every value of k, there is a corresponding E value, allowed energy value. But what is the values that K can take? What are the values that K can take? So the question is, what values can K have? What is this K and what values can K have? Recall from Bloch's theorem that the wave function associated with electrons in a semiconductor psi k are given by uk of r into e to the power of I k dot r. K is a vector, it's a propagation vector. I have not put the k notation here, and this will bring more concepts about the k and the band structure itself, because k is a propagation vector. So this is a plane wave. So it's a product of a plane wave and the Bloch cell function, which is a periodic Bloch cell function. Bloch cell function. Therefore, psi k is periodic. Now you know that the probability of finding an electron is equal to mod psi square. This is a periodic function. If we consider a semiconductor, let us say a small piece of semiconductor of dimensions. So let me mark the axis. So this is x, y, z. In space, I have taken a small piece of semiconductor, let's say cubic or a cuboid. So this is of dimension lx, ly, and lz. This height here is lz. Could be 1 mm by 1 mm. If it's a cube, Lx equal to Ly is equal to Lz equal to, let's say, a 1 mm cube size of semiconductor, a small piece of semiconductor. The electron is bound to the semiconductor, means you can find the electron inside but not outside. The electron is bound to the semiconductor, so it means it is inside the semiconductor, it is not outside. But we know that the probability of finding the electron is periodic, it is oscillatory function, therefore it is periodic. Therefore, if the electron has to be found inside and not outside, the probability is 0 outside, which means psi should go to 0 at the ends, at the boundaries. Psi should go to 0 at the boundaries, which means the wave function should form standing waves in the medium. This is called standing wave boundary conditions. There are also periodic boundary conditions or stationary wave boundary conditions. The logic is the field or the wave function has to go to 0 on the boundary of the semiconductor, which means if it has to go to 0 here and it has to go to 0 here, and if it is periodic and oscillatory, it means it must be forming standing waves. It is like this, you have a string which is clamped at two ends, the displacement is 0, and it is given that it can oscillate periodically. The displacement has to go to 0, which means it will oscillate either like this or like this, which are the modes of oscillations of string, which we study in school, modes of oscillations of a string. What is the boundary condition? That the displacement goes to 0 at the two ends. That immediately restricts the oscillation period or the wavelength here. As you can see, this is the smallest wavelength here, if I denote it by lambda, is equal to twice L, because this is L, this length is L. Please see, if I have a string of length L, then this is half the wavelength, and therefore lambda is equal to twice L. In this case, lambda is equal to L, so lambda is equal to L. You can have many more modes of oscillations of a string. Exactly like that, in this case, if the wave function has to form standing waves inside the medium, it means the phase, the round trip phase, please see that this is the phase, k dot r is the phase, e to the power of I phi, phi is the phase. So k dot r is the phase, and therefore twice k dot r, that is round trip phase, must be an integral multiple of 2 pi. This is the condition for standing waves. Round trip phase must be an integral multiple of 2 pi, which means the wave going from here to here and coming back should add in phase again. Therefore, in one round trip, the accumulated phase should be integral multiple of 2 pi. So the condition is 2 k dot r is equal to n times 2 pi. Now k is a vector, which means k is equal to I times kx plus j times ky plus, this is unit vector, okay, let me put k times kz. K has three components, k, the vector k is equal to kx, ky, kz. It's a propagation vector. Please see the space. This is space. If the electron is moving in this direction, this is the k. It has components in this direction, and in this direction. So it has x, y, z component. The electron could move like this. It could move like this. So depending on that, it will have different x, y, z components. If k dot r is equal to n times 2 pi, this means that therefore, because kx, ky, kz are orthogonal components of k, we must have kx is equal to p times 2 pi, ky is equal to q times 2y. Oh, one second. Let me use the notation as given in the book. Let me correct this. k dot r is equal to, please see what is k dot r? K dot r is kxx plus kyy plus kzz. It's a dot product. K dot r is kxx, kyy, kzz. The three components here. Now, if you consider this of dimension lx, ly and lz, then I must have twice kx into lx must be equal to m times integral multiple of 2 pi twice ky ly equal to p times integral multiple of 2 pi and twice kz lz is equal to integral multiple q times 2 pi. This is for the vector and it has components x, y and z which are orthogonal components. Therefore, if this is integral multiple of 2 pi, it means each of the components must also satisfy m times 2 pi, p times 2 pi and q times 2 pi, where m, p, q are, all of them cannot be 0. So, let me put 1, 2, 3 are integers, Yes. If this is equal to twice this is equal to in some integer times 2 pi, which means these are independent, the components are in, they are orthogonal components. Therefore, every one of them must be equal to an integer, and of course this MPQ is different from N, but because they are orthogonal components, every one of them, each of these terms have to satisfy round trip phase must be integral multiple of 2 pi. If you see in this picture, this is for a string that I have shown. Yes, it is applicable for all three axes and therefore each component must satisfy this equation. This means that kx is equal to pi divided by lx into m, ky is equal to pi divided by ly into p and kz is equal to pi divided by lz into q. And the propagation vector k is equal to x cap or I cap kx plus y cap j cap ky plus k cap kz. So k takes, k can take these values and where k is this and mod k, that is the magnitude of k is equal to kx square plus ky square plus kz square. To the power of mod k is equal to kx square, ky square, kz square. What is the point? The important point to note is k comprises of three components and each of these components are now discretized. They are discrete, which means the vector k itself is discrete. Please see kx, ky, kz take discrete values because m, p and q are integers. If kx, ky, kz are discrete, vector k will also be discrete. What it means is, if we go to the k space now, if we go to the K space, this is K space. Which means this is kx, ky, and kz. Any vector k can be represented by these three components. But the k values themselves take discrete values. The separation between these is pi divided by lx, because this is m equal to 1, pi by lx, 2 pi by lx, 3 pi by lx, and so on. Along y, it is so this is pi by ly, this is twice pi by ly, and so on. And similarly, this is also discretized. What is our objective? Is to determine rho of k, the density of states. The density of states is the number of states between k and k plus dk per unit volume of the material. So we want to find out what are the values that the k will take. So in general, the vector k, a vector k here will have an x component, it is here, a y component, it is this, and a z component is this. So this is the kx value here for this vector k. So this is the vector k, kx, ky, and kz. To proceed further, let us have an idea what kind of numbers will these be, how many such points will be there, and what kind of number is this. If lx, for example, let us take the one dimensional case, atoms are with an interatomic spacing A. Atoms are located periodically in a one-dimensional lattice with an interatomic space A. What is Lx? If the dimension Lx is equal to 1 mm, let us say we consider a cube with dimension Lx is equal to Ly is equal to Lz is equal to 1 mm. What is the smallest value of kx? M equal to 1. So pi divided by lx. So smallest value of kx is equal to pi divided by 1 mm. So 1 mm for m equal to 1, for m equal to 1, which is equal to 10 to the power of 3, because 1 mm, 10 power minus 3 meter, 10 to the power of 3 pi meter inverse. This is the value of k. K has length inverse, dimensions of length inverse, and as you can see, this is the smallest value of K for a cube of size 1 mm, Kx. What is the largest value of K? What do you think is the largest value of K? Because if we know that, then we can know what kind of numbers, how many points will be there. If, like in the EK diagram, you recall, in the EK diagram, we said that this is the boundary of the Brillouin zone, the first Brillouin zone. If you consider the reduced zone picture, then this value corresponds to K is equal to pi by A, and this is K is equal to minus pi by A. In the reduced Brillouin zone picture, this is the EK diagram, E versus K, we have K is equal to pi by A. The largest value is K equal to pi by A. How did we get this? K is equal to pi by A. If you see this, what is K? K is equal to 2 pi by lambda, where lambda is the de Broglie wavelength of electrons. lambda is the de Broglie wave. How do we imagine a lambda? The electron, which is a wave, does this. If this entire length is Lx, Lx is the entire length, then lambda, the wavelength, you can see wavelength lambda is equal to twice Lx, or Lx is equal to half the wavelength. The dimension Lx is equal to half the wavelength, or lambda is equal to twice Lx. Therefore, K is equal to 2 pi by lambda is equal to 2 pi by 2 Lx is equal to pi by Lx. You see, the same value I have got. I am trying to give you a picture. What could this be? A simplistic picture. Why that is the smallest value? Why Lx Kx is equal to pi by Lx is the smallest value? Because that corresponds to an electron de Broglie wavelength, which is like this from end to end. The fundamental mode in the case of a string. What is the largest value of K? It would correspond to smallest permitted value of lambda. Smallest permitted value of lambda will be, please see, this is an electron. The electron can do, it can do like this, or the electron wave can do like this. What do I mean by do like this? See this. If you assume an electron which is entering from here, the particle electron, it gets attracted towards the positive nucleus. So the electron bends towards the nucleus but gets scattered and it goes in this direction. When the electron goes in this direction, there is the next positive nucleus which is attracting it, so it starts bending towards this. It is getting attracted towards the positive nucleus here. So it takes a, so it can get attracted so much that it would again get scattered and start going in this direction, but the next one will attract it, and therefore the electron path, the path of the electron as a particle, can at best do this, the smallest path. On the other hand, if I have the electron coming from here, it could slowly get attracted, but it may not bend so much, but it could slowly get attracted and it may bend like this. And that corresponds to this. That corresponds to a large wavelength. If it is attracted rapidly, if the potential is strong, then it could do this. When it does this, what is the wavelength? The wavelength here corresponds to from maxima to maxima, this distance. And what is that? This is interatomic spacing A, and therefore this is equal to twice A. The wavelength lambda is equal to twice A. Please see this. This is the wavelength of electron, which is, this is interatomic spacing A. Therefore, the smallest wavelength that you can have is this, which means my K, largest value of K is equal to 2 pi divided by 2A, which is equal to pi by, which is consistent with this picture that the edge of the first Billmore zone is K is equal to pi by A. Now, why did I put this? The smallest value of Kx is this much. What is the largest value of K? So Kx, this is min, minimum value. What is Kx max? Is equal to pi by A. A is equal to 5 angstrom, which means pi divided by 5 into 10 to the power of minus 10 meter inverse, which is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of 9 pi meter inverse. Kx varies from about 10 to the power of 3 pi to 10 to the power of 9 pi. It varies by 6 orders of magnitude when you go from the minimum value here to the maximum value here. So from here, 10 to the power of 3 coming up to 10 to the power of 9 in steps of 10 to the power of 3, pi by Lx, in steps of 10 to the power of 3, what does that mean? The number of points that you have here is a million, 10 to the power of 3 to 10 to the power of 9 in steps of 10 to the power of 3. 1 million points, 1 million values of Kx permitted. And similarly, a million values of Ky and a million values of Kz. So what is the point? Every K is characterized by a value of Kx, Ky and Kz. Each one can take a million values, and therefore the combination can take billions of values. So the number of K values within one Villemot zone, that is the first band, is billions. Do you understand this point? And that is why I have put this number, to tell you that the number of points permitted, number of K points permitted, are of the order of a billion. Please ponder over this, because you have all, most of you would have calculated this density of states, and when you calculate, you make an assumption that the number of points in the K space is extremely large. By putting these numbers, the minimum and maximum, I have illustrated that indeed the number of K points permitted in the K space is extremely large. Therefore, if you plot in the K space, Kx, Ky, Kz, a billion points here, a million points here, a million points here, which means the permitted K values can be, there are enormous number of K values which are permitted in the K space. What am I making? Every point here corresponds to a K value, means the vector linking this to this point is an allowed value of K. And such billions of points in the K space. We will continue from here in the next class. Okay. We go for a quick quiz. So take a piece of paper. Here is the quiz. I hope you can see that. But those of you in the last bench, let me read it. The band structure of a particular semiconductor is given by this expression. E is equal to EC plus H cross square into K minus 5 whole square by 2MC for the conduction band, and EV minus H cross square K square by 2MV for the valence band. There are some parameters given. MC, that is effective mass of electron in the conduction band, is 0.2 times M0, MV is 0.8 times M0, and the band gap EG is 1.6 EV. The question is, draw qualitatively the band structure of this material. the expression for band structure is given. You are asked to draw qualitatively the band structure, making use of all the relevant data which is given. Any question? Is that clear to you? Is it visible? So, I am reading again. E is equal to EC plus H cross square into K minus 5 whole square divided by 2MC, and EV minus H cross square K square by 2MV. I thought the size was sufficient. Maybe next time we will increase the size. The question is, draw qualitatively the band structure of this material. No need to write the quiz question, just write the answer. That is, just draw the band structure.